direction. Yep. This is the parsonage. Quite a big house, actually.
Sheep stealing.
Well. Bachelor of Arts.
That was just his degree.
Like you. So this is a cabinet piano, is it?
Yes.
Very good.
The magnifying glass Mr. Bronte used for reading and many of his personal belongings are displayed here. This magnifying glass?
Yep, there it is.
Sure, I'll tell you the end of much of their writing. Mm. So, Jane Eyre, wondering how it's an atmosphere in this room. Oh, that's amazing to think, isn't it?
Mm-hmm. The library books.
The sisters would walk around the table discussing their writing after Emily and Anne died. Charlotte was left to walk in solitude. Oh. On the fireplace stands the rocking chair where Anne would sit with her feet on the fender, and it is believed that Emily died on the sofa in this room.
Oh, gosh. Oh. Wow.
She only lived to be 29, was she?
Something like that, yeah, yeah.
A plaster medallion.
Right.
Very nice.
Lovely.
Who's taking these? I don't know what it says on these things here, but it's interesting.
Just be a couple of minutes.
Yes. that is, yeah, it's great, isn't it?
Have you seen a picture of Otto?
Yes. Oh, yeah.
There's the washing thing.
That's good, isn't it? Yeah. Yeah. And not dissimilar to what we had at Grassfoot Road, actually. You know, the range, we had to be black leaded, and the, you know.
Did you have the washing on them?
Yes, up there. With, yeah, yeah.
I love those, all those pots and things,
aren't they? Yes, they're nice, aren't they? Gosh, that's a nice grandfather clock, isn't it? Bell for the to ring the servants. People have written. So I'm just from the point. Lord's Prayer up there, haven't we? Yeah. Yeah.
Well, he was the vicar then, wasn't he?
Yeah, it's another nice clock.
You've had this picture, have you?
No, I'm just about to do it, yes. That's very famous, isn't it?
Behind Wuthering Heights.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
Manchester.
Oh, yes, of course. Yeah. With the railway, they weren't. They could easily get into Manchester, couldn't they, from here?
Yeah, that's so. Gosh. Oh, Ackerman of 96 The Strand.
Okay. Swing up. Yeah. Thank you. Similar to yours, Ben, isn't it? Similar to yours.
You what?
Similar to yours.
Pneumatic puzzle wafers.
Yes. Fancy, isn't
it? Printed with acrostics.
Yeah. Mm. That's still one of the old. Sorry, I'm just trying to.
Used to store the diary papers written by Emily and Anne at irregular intervals. Gosh. The tin box was kept by Chicago's widower, Arthur Bell Nichols. Oh, and included in a sale held at Sotheby's in 1907 following his death.
Gosh, yeah.
What's that over there?
Charlotte Bronte up here.
Yeah. Oh, is it? Oh.
That's a lovely picture.
So this is Charlotte, is it? Yes.
She did Charlotte. She did go to Manchester and do things.
Then. Did she? Yeah. Well, say with the railway, just down the road.
That's right. They could go on the railway, couldn't they?
Yeah. Yeah.
Look at all these lovely
samplers.
That's Emily's up at the top there.
Oh right. So that's yeah.
Look at the top.
Okay, yeah, I can see you have a hand on the camera. Sorry, don't worry. Because it's behind glass, so we.
That's Charlotte Bronte's sampler.
Yes.
They're all keen on doing samplers.
Yeah. So this one. That's, and this is Mariah Branwell. So she was a. And noticed that little stool there, like the one we've got at home.
Oh, yes.
But it's in better condition than the one we've got.
Oh, it's the hat, isn't it?
The
that's
hat,
probably,
yes,
oh,
yes.
That's probably Anne Bonnet, just Bonnet.
Oh, yes.
This is, in later years, Branwell's. It was Branwell who was the pain in the neck.
Yes, of course. Yeah.
And he was addicted to alcohol, who made him a danger to himself and his family, and his father brought him into this room so he could watch over him, and it was here he died at the age of 31, repenting the fact that in all his life he had done nothing either great or good.
Oh, dear. That's not a very good epitaph, is it?
Not really. Oh, dear. Isn't that a beautiful chest of drawers?
It is, yeah. Yes, yes, it is, isn't it?
And the, oh yes, the jug to put your water in over there.
Yes, exactly, and his top hat too. And that's the,
oh, that's his top hat?
Yeah, the bedpan.
Yeah.
His top hat, I'm sorry, I'm just talking to camera. His top hat, and then, can't quite see really.
It's difficult to tell.
It is, isn't it? Yeah, but you say
anyway.
The,
we've got plenty of other ones.
Yeah, gosh, you see those things, sort of things in westerns, don't you, where they splash the water from the jug into the,
yeah,
you know,
yeah,
that'll be in the 1870s and 1880s even.
Yeah. Oh, they left this over here, this would be, oh,
chamber pot.
Nice.
Yeah. And even somebody's leftover bread.
Oh dear.
Mmm.
Gosh.
Well, that's the alcohol, presumably. Gosh. Oil lamp, gosh.
Yes, mustn't touch any.
Oh no, I'm not doing, don't worry. It's nice tankard. Yeah.
And then that's the church.
Yeah. Snuffer. Yes, you can. Sorry. You didn't by a chance see that gate there, did you, Nick, when you were in Brussels those years ago?
See what, sorry?
Gate here.
Oh, that, no.
No. So that's the first time you've seen anything about Anne Bronte. So, That's it. She was a keen musician. And she obviously then went to Scarborough, and that's where she died, and we shall be seeing that later. Of toy soldiers. Wow. So here you can tell where they are. So if I'm over this door, relative to the house, that was the bedroom. Yes, I will, yeah. Okay, and that was the dining room. So that's the dining room. Okay. Yes, I can. Stop by. It's like William Shakespeare, there. Fabulous chest. Looking through the looking glass. The actual size is there.